been teaching this course since around 2017 called VR Lab. And in the course, the students learn how to think about VR. It's really a kind of new way of telling stories. And it's almost as if we're telling stories on film in the early 20th century and just starting to learn how to use the new medium. They also learn how to use VR cameras and editing equipment. And then we always work with a local partner. This semester, we've been working with the Penn Museum. They are renovating the Egypt galleries, and we've been telling three virtual reality documentary stories about that. So we ended up focusing on the people who were involved. So one film is about the curators, another is about the conservators, and a third one about the archivist and archive.
The project has been really fun. It's all about 360 videos and 360 film. We developed a script. We coordinated with the curators of the museum. And we basically just got everything going smoothly very quickly. And it was a really good experience.
We've been following kind of the behind the scenes of how people have worked to make the gallery come together. It really is interesting, and to be able to walk through the warehouse and be so close, you know, it's not like there's glass around it or it's in this encasement. It's like you're there and you're so close to these ancient ruins, and then kind of going back and thinking, oh my God, how did this get here? This is so amazing. We took it from this archaeological dig spot, and now it's like in our proximity and I'm so close to it. It's just so filled to the brim with all of these incredible artifacts.
It was really great to work with the Wegners, Joseph and Jennifer Wegner. We had a lot of ideas about what we wanted them to say and sort of the artifacts that we wanted them to touch on, and they were able to bounce back even better ideas or just more collaborative ideas.
I've been one of the project curators for the reinstallation project of the Penn Museum's Egyptian and Nubian galleries. It's been a long, ongoing process. We've been working with Dr. Peter DeCherney's class doing a VR documentary, a coverage of the whole sort of curatorial process and conservation project involved in the, particularly the reinstallation of the Merentah Palace.
So I'm very excited about 360 video, virtual reality, as a way of telling documentary stories. You have presence in the space. You feel like you're there if you're a viewer. It's not like you're an invisible voyeur looking at a flat screen. You can look around. You don't just see the things that the filmmaker tells you to see, and your attention isn't focused in the same way. But I think slowly we are getting better at using the medium to tell stories, and more people have access to the technology to view them. And it's just a totally new way of telling stories. We can tell stories that we couldn't tell before. We can tell some of the same stories in ways that were hard to tell before.
I think this is a great project that's, I mean, it comes at a perfect time because we're at this sort of juncture in our curatorial process where we've kind of finalized the vision for the galleries, and we're working very closely with conservation on the treatment and preparation of those materials. These are all things that take a lot of energy and input, and oftentimes what happens in the midst of everything that's going on, people forget to sort of document it and tell the story. So the fact that these students are putting together this, you know, sort of interesting look at that whole project from a number of different facets, I think it's going to be a wonderful set of videos to have kind of telling that story.
I think it's great for documentary context. I think it's great for interactive storytelling. I think it'd be great to kind of bring it into sports and sit courtside at a game. I think that would be really cool. I think there's so many different applications of it that I want to stay in the conversation, and I want to keep seeing like where it goes after.